Hello, in today's video I'm going to show you how to make a pipe reduction like this. And for it you are going to need to make a template like this one. It's quite easy, so let me show you. So after you have done your template, all you have to do is wrap it around the pipe. This one is a little bit bigger, but hey, for demonstration it's gonna be all okay. So then you mark these lines, or you can use the template itself and cut it off with angle grinder, these segments in the circle. So after you have done that, add a little bit of 45 degree chamfer on these edges, deburr the inside, heat it with a burner here and hit it with the hammer, so it's gonna bend like this. You can see it in video. At the end I'm going to put a few pictures, so check it out how it looks like when it's made. So after you have heated it and bent it, don't hit the tip because you can damage the pipe. It's gonna bend and it's gonna look ugly, and it's quite difficult to straighten it. So slowly go and heat these segments, and that's it. Slowly hit them with a hammer until you get the conical reduction like this. Then of course weld it and grind it off. I have put 45 degrees chamfer on the pipes because it's gonna leave enough room for the weld. When you grind it off, you will still have weld, so that's why. So let's see how to make a template like this. To make it, you are going to need to know four values, three for the calculator that I'm using. So D1 is the diameter of the big pipe. D2 is smaller pipe outside diameter as well. We are dealing with outside diameters. L is the length of the reduction, and alpha angle is the angle of reduction. For calculation, we are going to use half the angle. So for example, if you want to make a 30 degrees reduction, in this case you are going to use half, so that's 15 degrees while calculating. I'm using online calculator. I'm too lazy to do trigonometric functions, so I'm gonna put it in description below so you can check it out. It's very useful. So once we know our diameter of the big pipe, we are going to multiply it by 3.14, and then we are going to draw the line on the piece of paper of the same length. After that, we are going to divide that line in number of segments that you want. In this case it is 6 divisions. You can put 8, you can put 12, whatever number you want. The more divisions, the rounder the pipe will look like, but if your length of the taper is short, it's gonna be hard to put 12 divisions on a small pipe like half an inch, so do it accordingly to your pipe size. So, but for this example I'm using 6 divisions, so let's continue to step 3. We are going to extend those lines of 6 divisions. The length of these lines will correspond with the length of the taper, or in this case pipe reduction. After we have done that, we are going to split these 6 divisions in half. So let me show you the numbers. So it will look like this. After that, we are going to take in step 4 D2, which is small pipe diameter, and we are going to multiply it by 3.14. Then we are going to divide it by the same number of divisions as in step 2. And then we are going to divide it by 2. Why 2? Because we are going to take that number that we got from all of this, and we are going to put it, we are going to mark the lines on the left and on the right side of these half divisions that we did in step 3. So our fourth operation will look like this. In fifth part, we are going to connect the lines. So we are going to connect these quarter lines to the lines that we did in step 3, the green ones. So we connect these red lines to the green ones like this. I hope you can understand it. Then I also add 20 more millimeters for convenience, for easier, it's easier to wrap it around the pipe, our template. So 20 millimeters. I also add 5 more extra millimeters, but just on these 20 millimeters, so it's gonna wrap around the pipe and it's easier to connect everything. In this case, I'm using electrician tape. You can also put a piece of tape here and on the pipe, so it won't move anywhere. You can use a zip tie as well. So, okay, let me show you this part. So, these lines over here correspond to these lines over here that we cut with angle grinder on our pipe. And this part here corresponds with these parts on the template. As I said, 20 millimeters extra, and that's it. That's how you make a template like this. I hope you understood me. That would be it for today's video. Thank you for watching, and until next time, goodbye.